I think I want to go to first. Okay, let me do this, then I'll tell you how I'm going to go. Okay, let me tell you how I got this. Y'all know I was, with Deb and I was on vacation. We just got back this morning, early this morning. But one day, I woke up. I mean, I was having a great, this is probably the best vacation we've ever had. Well, you know, glory to glory and all that stuff, you know. But one day I woke up and I'm like, dog, I wasn't feeling like I was on top. You know, I'm normally my feeler is pretty much developed now. I got my feeler working for me. But that morning I was like, oh God, Jesus, I don't feel like, what happened? I'm like, what happened when I was asleep? You know? And so it wasn't bad or anything, it's just a feeling. It's the same feeling you get. I titled this, What to Do When You Don't Feel Saved. That's my title tonight. I know y'all probably never get there, but the Reverend gets there sometime too. But what to do when you don't feel saved? Because our feelings, they come and they go, and a lot of times you don't, I mean, you can leave a, well, let me ask you, let's take a quick survey. How many of you have maybe come out of one of your greatest prayer sessions? Maybe just come from an awesome service and Minister Lynn just threw it down. And you came out, oh, devil, you better watch out on tonight. And you may get a phone call, an email, a text, or just a dart, pow, to your head. And you seem to lose, it's almost like, what just happened? I can't explain it. And so a lot of times, if we're not careful, we'll buy into that. I heard somebody say this other day, one of the greatest, and y'all need to listen to me real good, one of the greatest weapons that the enemy has in manifestation now is deception. And the Bible said the very elect, yes. I think that covers everybody in here. Everybody watch me. The very elect can be deceived. And it's not one of those things where we say, well, not me, I confess that. No, it's not that, don't keep it from coming. It's got to be something that I'm actually on top of. But anyway, go to 2 Corinthians chapter 4. Put it on the screen, please. I want to use several scriptures, because when I woke up, you know, feeling off, you know, just off. This is when the devil speaks to you the loudest, when you're feeling off. Yes, not when you're feeling powerful, like, come on, bring it on. No, he speaks the loudest. He's the father of lies, and he speaks the loudest. But one of the things, and I thank God. God said, no, he said, you don't pay attention to that, because what really matters hasn't changed. Now, here's the scripture that says, but we have this treasure where? In earthen vessels. You know what the earthen vessel is? That's just this body here. Inside this body, inside this awesome specimen, and your awesome specimen, is what God calls a treasure. Glory to God. Man, there's something in me that God calls a treasure. I don't care what them folks down the street call it. God said, there's something in you, boy, that's precious. You can't buy it with silver or gold. It cannot be matched. You cannot place a value on it because it's too precious. It's a treasure. Everybody don't have it, does not have it. But if you're born again, you got one. He said, but we have this treasure where? That the excellence of the power may be of God and who? And not us. So that wiped out all this what I was feeling, because God said, what you're feeling is on the outside that's going to decay and not be here, but, you know, maybe 100 years, maybe, I don't know. But you got something inside of you that what you have to do is go beyond what you're feeling and go beyond what's coming to your mind and all of that, because you have something inside of you that's greater and that will manifest the power of God, not you. the power. We just sang that song. Your power is amazing. And so when we're singing that, I'm thinking about all this treasure in here. See, that's why we can't be so caught up in other people's opinion, because if they don't know Jesus and don't know the Bible, they don't know their opinion, their appraisal is not accurate. Say, I got something in me. Okay, and then it says that the excellence of the power, may be of us and not of God. May be of God and not of us. You have something in you. 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 The Bible says sin shall no longer have dominion over us. Why? I got power in me over sin. Nothing dominates me, not even coffee. No, I mean, you got to start thinking like, what? I'm not letting anything dominate me and control me. No. I got power in me. It doesn't matter what I feel. It doesn't matter what somebody told me. Isn't it amazing how you can be going along having a good day and get one phone call from somebody and they say something and then like, bam, wow. See, we got power over that. I'm not saying it doesn't happen. It's very real. But what we got to do is draw. We got to draw on what's inside of us. Because you may not have Minister Lynn to lay hands on you. You may not have Pastor Finley to speak to your mountain. You got something greater than both of them put together. You got the power of God inside in this earthen vessel. So you need to keep this vessel in shape. You need to keep this vessel vitaminized and whatever, you know, keep it feeling good. Why? Get your sleep. Why? Because if the vessel wear down, you'll be prone not to even draw from the power. That's why this vessel is important. Now the devil try to keep, well, you know, the devil's something, man. He would be like, you know, if you don't get this, you're like, well, you know, your body ain't that important. No way, because, you know, it's only going to be here for a little while. You know, bodily exercise profit a little. Isn't that what the scripture says? But he'll use it like, it ain't that much. Gone and die at 45. Gone and die. You can't even walk up the stairs breathing without breathing hard. You see, you know, it's okay. God love you, though. I'm not saying that to be mean. I'm saying that because this earthen vessel, listen, that treasure, where's the treasure at? Okay, check this out. That earthen vessel can only do and demonstrate power, I mean the treasure, as long as the vessel is moving. One of the things I pray, I said, Lord, I don't just want to be healed, you know, so I can wear them body shirts and whole. I want to be healed. I want to glorify you and be of service to other people. I don't need strength for me. It don't take much, just sit around. You don't need much strength. I need strength. Hallelujah. To go about doing good. Healing all that are oppressed of the devil. So I'm not putting down this earthen vessel. But anyway, let me get to what I want to talk about. Go to Hebrews chapter 10. Thank you, Lord. So what do you do when you don't feel saved? Maybe I should use another title. When you just don't feel saved. Your mouth ever get there? Not feeling to your mouth, be like, I just want to cuss. Your mouth, you know you saved though. You got a fish on the back of your car. Okay, but here's what I want to talk about. Okay, so Pastor, what'd you do? Well, I'm about to tell you, but the Bible says the flesh profits nothing. So I don't pay attention to my flesh. Well, I don't pay attention to it. No, I pay attention to it like when it's hurt, that, you know, I need to get something. But I don't pay attention to it when it comes to where I'm at with God. You flow with me? My flesh does not dictate to me where I'm at with God. It doesn't dictate to me whether I'm really walking with God or I'm all out. My flesh doesn't dictate. In my flesh dwelleth no good thing. My flesh is enmity. My feelings, I don't ever feel like doing the things of God. My flesh doesn't ever feel like it. I have to make it. See, Paul said, and I'm going to get to it. Remember Paul said, I I got this. You had your turn. That's my girl out there. But Paul said, I buffet, not buffet, not Golden Corral buffet. It's spelled the same way, though, isn't it? Buffet. Yeah, he said, I buffet this body. I make this thing sit down and shut up. I make this mouth hold your tongue. Yeah, I know you can do what you hold it. Your body do whatever you let it do. It's like a little child. If you don't discipline it, it'll just run all over the place. You got to make yourself not lie. You got to make yourself not just lay down and let. You got to make yourself. Yes, I want to drink. You ain't drinking nothing. I'm going to go 30 days. I'll go 60 days. You better shut up. You got to talk to yourself. You got to talk to your flesh. Boy, I'm horny. You better talk to it. I've been on vacation, huh? I'm sorry. How many of y'all flesh? Don't wave your hand. No. I would tell it. Anyway. That's a natural body function. But you better control it. That ain't no different than having an anger issue. Man, y'all better shoot. If y'all can look at my ledger, y'all wouldn't be laughing. Right, Jim?
Yes, sir.
And my appointment ledger. You better control that flesh. Paul said, I buff it. What he meant by that was, he said, I discipline it. I don't let this thing run all over the place. I don't stay on the phone all night talking. I know I ain't got no business staying on the phone all night talking. Make that flesh get off the phone. Oh, I hadn't thought about all that. Well, that's the flesh. Can't never be on time. That's not a genetic thing. That's the flesh. How many of y'all know people just can't on time for nothing? Okay. Yeah, that's the plan. You got to discipline yourself. Listen, we're going to leave 20 minutes early. I don't want to take 5 minutes to get there, but you don't seem to understand. You seem to think it's okay to be late and disrespect people's time. I'm talking about this because, see, my flesh wanted to tell me the other day, You ain't all that spirit. What? But what do? You let the flesh know who's in charge. I'm in charge. It don't look like the word working for you. Listen. You don't have anything to say about this. You don't know nothing about this. This is spiritual. This is all spiritual. So quit trying to tell me what's going on in my life. You don't even know spiritual stuff. I'm telling you, you got to talk to that thing. The flesh, the Bible said, the flesh profits nothing. It's enmity. In other words, whatever is good for me, it really doesn't even know. But one thing about it, though, it'll flow whatever way you dictate and demand it and command it to go. It'll flow. A lot of people get in a lot of trouble because they can't control that flesh. You think about some of the time, you know, way back there, on the other side, when you like, man, I should have shit up right there at that, and I shouldn't have, shoot. Okay. So what do you do? Y'all remember, you know, when I was here, we were talking about praising and thanking God. One of the things you do to shut that flesh down, you begin to thank and praise God. God, you're so good. You begin to sing, Lord, your power was amazing. I didn't know how I could make it, but your power was amazing. Your strength is awesome. Now, one of the things that causes us not to feel inspired or saved, and it is normal. Everybody say it's normal. Is something that we become developing. You in Hebrews chapter 10? Yeah. Thank you, Lord. Okay. Y'all bear with me tonight, okay? Because I may jump around on you, because... okay, let me say this first. No, okay, let's read the scripture. Verse 1. For the law, having a shadow of things, good things to come, and not the very image of the I can't believe I said that. Image of the thing can never, with these same sacrifices which they offer continually year by year, make those who approach perfect. So he was talking about the law where they had to bring sacrifices to animals year after year. Verse 2. For then would they have not ceased to be offered. If they were perfect, they would have stopped. For the worshipers, everybody say the worshipers. That's us. Once purified, would have had no more consciousness of sin. Now, I wanted to read that because this is something God kind of spoke to me about when I was talking about that. Is he says one of the enemies, and one of the things the enemy preys on with the deception is the sin consciousness. And what that means is, you know, anybody here never made a mistake at all? You've never made a mistake. How many of you never made it? You haven't made a mistake in 30 days. You have not made a mistake in 30 days. You're like, oh, I ain't made a mistake. How about 3 weeks? Okay, how about 3 hours? Okay. Now, the reason why I say that, because he talks about when once we're purified, there's supposed to be no sin consciousness. Sin consciousness dwells on the mistakes we made. Dwells on, well, God's not gonna heal me because I did this and I promised him I wouldn't do this again. Sin consciousness dwells on, well, you know, if I hadn't done this, maybe my child wouldn't have turned out this way. Sin consciousness dwells on, I know God is paying me back. How many of y'all, well, never mind. I know God is paying me back. Today, you know, I'm gonna do my best today. I'm gonna do my best not to go there, but I know I probably will go there. That's sin consciousness. Some people make plans to fail. The Bible says make no provision for the flesh, right? Some people make provision for the flesh. That's a sin conscience, always looking at the bad side of it. Well, after we receive Jesus, God wants us to be God conscious. Now, you told me none of you made a mistake in the last 3 hours. But here's the deal. That's okay. We all gonna make, you're gonna make some in the next 3 hours. But God wants you God conscious. What does that mean? That my sins have already been taken care of. Instead of like, oh God, I see some people, there's no boldness in prayer. They like, I'm not gonna go over there and pray for them. You don't know what I just did. You don't know what I did last week. See, God conscious says, yeah, I did that, yeah. But that's why Jesus hung on that cross. I'm the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus. All my sins have been forgiven and wiped away. I'm a brand new creature in Christ. If I confess my sin, he's faithful and just to forgive me of all sin and cleanse me of all unrighteousness. He just sent my sin far the east is from the west. So I'm remembering now what Jesus did. I'm remembering what he did. I'm remembering what he made. My consciousness is I'm the righteousness of God. What does that mean? I'm right with God. Now, if I sin, don't, you know, if I, when you, no, not if, if, when you sin, when we sin, don't stay there. Why? Because it's an open door for the devil. It's not God, not all of the, well, they punish me. No, the devil punishing you. God ain't punishing you. He, in Hebrew, he said, he once and for all. Jesus ain't getting back on the cross to deal with my sins anymore. But my sin opens the door, pow, allow for the devil. Come on in here and have your way. That's why I need to close it as soon as I know it's open. You confess your sin, you're faithful and just to forgive us of all unrighteousness. What does that do? See, when we sin, we break fellowship. We don't break relationship. We break fellowship. I'm still the son, but ain't nobody fellowshipping with me. So I confess it to cleanse that and restore my fellowship back to God. The Bible says, come boldly to the throne of grace. See, that's so much God wants to do with us. And most of us have disqualified ourselves. Because we feel like, because the sin will keep me over here like, well, I'm an ass, but I got to get two days, you know, two clean days before I go ass. Okay, maybe y'all don't feel that way. I used to feel that way. I said, if I could be straight for a week and not do that again, then I come to the throne. And that's a trick of the enemy. How you doing, child? I don't know if I'm a third today, because shoot. You know, I don't want to be the weak link in the chain today, because, you know, we want the anointing of God. Anointing of God ain't going to flow, because I'm kind of dirty right now. Huh? No, that's the mindset. He wants you to think what you did caused God to fall off the throne, and God ain't going to use you. Who else he going to use? We all dirty. Except for the blood of Jesus. We all dirty. We all do. I'm thinking about some of them. Okay, never mind. think about, you know, I remember seeing the cartoon one time. You know how they had the captions over the cartoon? What if, see, y'all know what I was going to say, right? Yeah, because all kind of stuff, you can't stop stuff from coming to your mind. It's not you. Now, if you act on it, now you got a problem. But you can't stop stuff from coming. All kind of stuff come to your head. Like, God, dog. but that's not me. So he wants me God conscious. So it's so sweet when you become God conscious. So okay, Pastor, you weren't feeling it. What'd you do when you weren't feeling it? I just started reminding myself about this trash and earthen vessel. That Jesus is living a lot, is living big in me. Lord, thank you. You redeemed my life from destruction. Can't no devil take me out? Can't no cancer take me out? Can't no pneumonia or cold or hangnail take me out. You redeemed my life from destruction. I'm redeemed from that. That's what you said about me. You said I'm accepted in the beloved. I don't care if the folk don't like me. I do. Yes, I do. I care, but I'm not going to lose no sleep over it because I'm accepted. Everybody needs acceptance. I'm coming to you for it. Now, whether they recognize how awesome I am or not, I'm still going to stay with you till they get a revelation. Some of them are going to have to wait till they get to heaven to find out how awesome I was. Hallelujah. Christians with sin consciousness can't see themselves the way God sees them. Man, if you can see how God sees you, you have a hard time getting to sleep at night. I'm not talking about insomnia. You just be so excited. Like, God, I don't know why. Wow, Lord, thank you. And the devil try to put in your head, well, you better enjoy this night. Because you... Anybody ever had thoughts like, I mean, yeah. Okay, you, and God forbid you're on the plane with a whole bunch of turbulence. You're like, boy, okay, I thought I'd go up there like, Captain, give me the mic. Folks going crazy. I'm like, well, I'm all right. Well, what if the plane go down? It go down. I made up my mind. This is just me. You do what you want to do. I made up my mind. I ain't fearing nothing.
Come on, God.
I ain't fearing nothing. Fearing nothing. If I die, what's the worst that can happen if I die?
Awesome.
Everybody here going to be all right. I ain't coming back either. No, I mean, you gotta process things like, I refuse to fear. I remember time, that would be time in my life, I was scared to answer the phone. If you ever been in some of the situations I've been in, you wouldn't answer them either. But when we have a sin consciousness, we can't come boldly, unashamedly to God. I've had the devil try to tell me, how are you going to lay hands on people? Who you think you are anyway? I said, I don't think, I know. I just read about who I am. Thank you, Lord. So I want to, let me give you some basic things, because this is the basic. This is basic, but it's a good reminder, because we need to know and not draw back. This is show and tell time, y'all. I said, this is show and tell time. It's time to see some manifestations of what God said, not just going to church and all that. It's show and tell time. It's time to have some fun and show and tell, and the light shines brighter the darker it is. Okay, now I want you to go to, let's do this. Go to 2 Corinthians chapter 5. I know you know this, but let's do it. Thank you. Everybody say Christ conscious.
Christ conscious.
Yeah. So when you get a bad report, you go to the doctor and they try to tell you this is going on. And that's okay, but your conscience, well, you know, Jesus bore that. Thank you, Lord. Jesus took care of that for me. And they try to get you, hey, you know, we're going to give you something to calm down your nerve. No, I have the peace of God. See, God conscious. I have the peace of God that passes all understanding. Hallelujah. God conscious. I don't know if I'm doing a good job with this part of it, but I got to be God conscious. There got to be something coming out of me that's God.
Yes.
There's got to be something, and it's in me. It's in me. Where's it at? It's in this earth. So sometimes people say, well, I just can't help it, just the way I am. No, that's the way you want to be. Because as a believer, everything you need that pertains to life and godliness is already in you. It's already in you. So when we miss the mark, we don't dwell on failures. We dwell on Jesus. Now, 2 Corinthians 5:17. Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, he is a what? Old things have passed away, and behold, all things have become new. Now, all things are of who? Oh. Old things passed away, all things have become new, and now I'm finding out that all those things, the new thing, are of, came from, part of, came out of God's factory. All that new stuff that's in me. You get that? So everybody here born again, that's born again, there's something in you now that wasn't in you before, and God put it in there. It's of him. Okay? Man. Okay, now all things are of God, who has reconciled us to himself through Jesus Christ and has given us the ministry of reconciliation. So I got some new stuff in me. Now I can be reconciled back to God and fellowship with him because of what Jesus did. That is that God is in Christ reconciling the world to himself, not imputing their trespasses to them, and has committed to us the word of condemnation. No, a word of reconciliation. We're supposed to be letting folks know. We're not supposed to be telling them how bad they are. Tell them, look, man, you can be reconciled back to God. Now then, we are ambassadors for Christ, as though God were pleading through us. He's working through us. We implore you on Christ's behalf, be reconciled to God. For he made him who knew no sin to be sin for us, that we might become the righteousness, what? Of God in him. So right, that means that I am right. I'm as right with God as Jesus is, because I'm in him. Man, I am as right with God because I'm in Christ. So God sees me through Christ. So I got a consciousness now. I don't see Jesus. I don't see Jesus having to go to the psyche man and sit down and get somebody to analyze him. When the devil put pressure on him, I don't see Jesus going all off like, oh my God, what are we gonna do? I'm so depressed right now. We don't see Jesus doing that. So I'm in whatever Jesus had in him that kept him from doing that is in me now. It's in me now. I saw Jesus healing folk. I didn't see Jesus needing healing, but I saw him healing folk. Whatever was in him, working in him, now is in where? It's in me. It's in that treasure. Okay, let me slow down. Because this is the key. Man, this is key. First of all, he said, in Christ. So those who are truly born again, everybody say truly. I'm still going to do that sermon about the fake church versus the real church. No, really, I got to, because there's a lot of people who think they're saved. Okay, so anyway, those who have truly received Jesus. Got something in them. Now notice, he said that the believer is a new creation. Old thing passed away, not going to pass away. Not going to pass away once we get to heaven. Old things have already passed away. So every real believer in here, something old left you and something new that God put in you. What was that, Pastor? Okay. Now, if you're 5'6" and pounds, you're going to still be 5'6". Pounds after you get born again. If you had dentures before you got born again. But you know what? I know people that got teeth though. It was a working a miracle. Yeah, that's true. Okay, let me use another one. If you was a man when you got saved. I know. But you know what I'm saying. You still a man after you receive Christ. If your memory was bad before you got saved, your memory is still going to be bad after the born-again conversion. Now, you can fix that, you can change that, you can upgrade it. But my point is, everything that changed is brand new. You can't see it, you can't feel it, you can't touch it. Because it wasn't in your body, and it wasn't in your soul. Your soul is your mind, your will, your imagination, your feelings. None of that got new. None of that was new. I know we used to sing a song in Bethel Baptist Missionary Church. I looked at my hands looked. I looked at my feet. And they did too. You know, I'm not gonna come against someone's imagined perceived experience. But that didn't happen with God. So what did happen was my standing with God became perfect. Perfect. I'm as right with God as Jesus is because I'm in him and I accepted everything he did for me. That's what became new. Where did that become new at? Okay, give me 1 Thessalonians 5:23. I know you know this, but when this is solid in you, you'll never again be moved by what you feel, see, hear, or what folk tell you, what report the folks in the white coat bring you. Okay, now may God the peace himself sanctify you completely, and may your whole what? Spirit. Soul and body be preserved blameless at the coming of our Lord. Okay, and I know I taught on this before, but the spirit, soul, and body. So what became new? The spirit. I just explained the soul and the body, nothing happened to that. Now you can make something happen. But the part of you that's brand new, that never existed before, was your spirit. And you cannot monitor what's going on in your spirit by what you feel, by what you see, oh my God, I just got that, Lord, okay. You can't monitor. That's why, this happened to me one time. I was standing for healing when I had this sleep apnea thing. And I'm standing for healing. I think about 6 months. And one night I went to bed with it and I woke up and it was gone. I had a sinus deal. They were getting ready to do surgery. I said, no, just hold off. I'm gonna be okay. And I came up, don't tell them, but I lied a little bit so I wouldn't have to go see them. I know, the Lord forgave me. That was back in the early 80s. I wasn't as sanctified as I am now. I would have came up with a really good excuse. But no, they had me scheduled. I can't come today. I don't even know what I thought. But I went to bed one night, Brenda, and I woke up, gone. Watch this. See, however God wants to hear you, I'm fine with it. But see, some people recover, and some people sick one night, make they gone. Why? Because, why? Because healing comes out of my spirit. I love you, Jesus. Because healing is the life of God. The Bible said in Romans 8:11, the same spirit that raised Jesus from the dead is living in me. And so I'm taking my time to go in because, see, if I can get my soul and my spirit to agree, it's just a matter of time. It's just a matter of time for manifestation because my body has no choice but to obey it. How? And that's with anything. That's with any promise of God. See, your spirit, no. That's why you can sit here sometime and you're like, okay, well, how long is it? How long? But something inside of you is like, ooh, this is good. Oh, Lord, I don't understand the word he's saying, but I just feel something. No, that's not true. I don't think it is. I don't know. It might be. But you just know. And maybe you've been taught something different, but something inside you say, you know, I don't even agree with him, but something. That's why you can know stuff. How many if you knew something in here before you knew it up here? Yeah. Yeah. See, the Bible says the spirit of man is the candle of the Lord. That's what God gonna light. Put some light first. And that's why, boy. And that's why you gotta read this word. See, I know the devil wanted his deceptions to keep you out of this word. He, you know, listen to praise music all day. That has to play. But if you don't have that word, your soul can't get in agreement with your spirit already. No! And so you need to feed on that word. Feed on what? The greater is he that's in me than he that's in the world. Well, it don't feel like it. Just say it. Just say it. By his stripes, I'm healed. It don't look like, don't look like I'm healed. I don't care. You working on your mind. You working on your soul, your feeler, your thinker, your emotional, your imaginer. You working on your mind. No, it's the truth. Because sometimes you meditate in the word like, okay, what is this going to do? God, what time is Steve Harvey show come on? You know, and you're working, but no, you're working on something, baby. You're working on something. Turn that thing on. Unplug the TV. Cut the cable cord, whatever you got to do. I'm working on something. I got to get my soul in agreement with my spirit. I got to get me some soul food. I got to get some soul food so I can get down here and get it working. Because once it agrees with my spirit, it's all over but the shouting. And that's why the devil don't want you to take time. He wants you to fuss and argue and come up with reasons why I can't work and all of that. Deception. And then you find somebody that's like on it. See, there they go. Who they think they are. No, you got to know how to work this thing. See, to your soul. And sometimes it takes time. I told God, I said, God, I don't care. You know, I'm going to do whatever I need to do. Because I won't get in trouble with you. But I'm going to stay in this word for the people. I'm going to keep pointing them to the word of God. Because I know long after I'm gone, they can take that word and conquer anything in their lives. You can do this. I can do this. And I'm getting fed now. You got to feed that soul. Y'all remember, I don't know if you remember, I had a diagram up here. Spirit, soul, and body. And the spirit, the body can't touch the soul. But the spirit, I mean the spirit's over here, soul, body. See, you, the soul is kind of like the regulator of what, of the power that's released in your life. That's why the devil don't want to, that's why he don't want to understand in scripture. He won't think, well, you know, if the Lord, if the one of the Lord feels like it. No, it's when you get your soul in agreement with what the spirit said. And so the spirit way over here, the body can't touch it. But the body, the soul is right here. It touches the body, it touches the spirit, and the body. And so that's why he said in 3 John 2, beloved, I wish above all things that you would prosper, walk in divine health, even as your soul prosper. So if my soul is prospering in the word, it's gonna flow over here. And the spirit's like, that's what I'm talking about right there. And the body has no other choice but to follow through. Because you got two against one. But here again, back to what I said earlier. You got that treasure, earthen vessel. You already got the power. Ask God, send your power. Where's he gonna get it from? He already put it in you. The transformation of any situation in your life can be expedited by the renewing of the mind, the renovation of the mind, of the soul, your feelings. That is such a low level of existence in God. Now, obviously, you need it. You know, the stove is hot. Huh, that's hot. Okay. You need it for that. But when it comes to where God is, some of the biggest manifestations we've ever had, I mean the biggest, hugest, magnanimous, enormous, mucho, is when, you know, it's like, okay, let's do this. And out of nowhere, bam. Because your soul don't know, you can't touch your spirit. So how do I know, Pastor? How do I know what's going on in this other spirit realm you're talking about? I'm glad you asked that, sugar. Because the word of God is the only way you can know. Jesus said, my words are spirit and life. Didn't he say it? Yeah, he said the word of God is like a mirror. You're looking through the mirror to see how you're looking. Don't you? And so when you look into the word and it says that by his stripes you're healed, okay, that's what's happening in my spirit right there. Your spirit has completely changed. And God is trying to get you to yield to it. We all know. Like I said, we know there's something. We use terms like, I had a hunch. How many of you? Oh, Lord. I'm going to close my eyes on this one. Because I'm almost embarrassed. I'm almost embarrassed on this one. How many of you made a decision or something only to find out later? Man, I know I wasn't supposed to do that. Duh! There was something scratching on the inside. Like, no, don't do that. Spirit of man is the candle. That's what God talked to you. When people say, well, I heard God, they're not talking about these ears. That's what God speaks on the inside. That's why you got to master getting quiet. Especially if it pertains to your life and something that's gonna affect you for a long time. Learn how to get quiet. Be still. And know that I'm God. Why? Because all the answers in there. What else is in there? Jesus made them to me. Wisdom, righteousness, sanctification, redemption. Galatians 5:22 says joy. Joy is already in there. Peace, it's already in there. I have to summon. Strength is in there. Faithfulness is in there. Being on time is in there. You know what? It is. It really is. I mean, you can be... Mike, I got your text or email the other day. I was on vacation, so I wasn't trying to answer nothing about church. You know, and so I don't. But he asked me, I made a statement last week that you need to become the active force in the change of your life. How many of y'all remember that? Okay, I'm gonna give him the answer in front of all y'all while y'all can, he asked the question. Don't ever be stupid. This is not the answer. What I mean by that is, people, it's amazing to me, People don't ask questions. If you don't know, ask somebody. Try to figure out, well, I'm with the Lord. No, ask somebody if you think they know. If they don't know, ask, keep asking until you find out. Anyway, but I said, you need to be the active force. That means it's simple. I mean, I know it's kind of self-explanatory, but that's where you say, okay, like we're talking about this here. Get my soul to agree with my fear. I'm not gonna wait on pastor. I'm not gonna wait on Crepolo. I'm not waiting on nobody else. Friendly gonna take the bull by the horn, and I'm gonna get this, and I'm not gonna stop until I get understanding, until something change, my life change, if I gotta discipline myself. And see, that's normally the thing. I'm gonna discipline myself to stay on one thing until I get it, until I conquer it. I don't need to be doing 25 other things. I don't need 15 voices telling me what to do. I'm gonna become the what force? Active force. And that means I'm gonna take responsibility. I'm not gonna play the blame game. This is me. If it ain't happening, it's because of me. Wave at me, Mike, because I don't want the people behind you think I'm talking about them. Okay. And she was looking at me like, whoa, I didn't say nothing, bro. I saw you, baby. I saw you. Yeah. So sometimes you know you gotta do that. Come forward like, golly, he ain't gotta be all like that on me. But active force. What is it that you know? You know, I know New Year's coming up. Everybody got that. Look, man, bunker calendar. You start tomorrow. I'm gonna do some stuff next week. I'm going after this. I told Deb, I said, I'm gonna do this. I ain't coming back until I'm done. Now I went on vacation. That was like, whew, the rest and all that. The other thing is for ministry. And I do this all the time. I'm the active force. I'm not waiting. Come by here, Jesus. No. I'm not coming by here. I'm going up hither. Didn't he say, come on up here? And see, you become the active force. Like the one I'm talking about here. My spirit, I got to get my soul. So, program yourself. You know, just, Dr. B, you had to turn the TV off, what, about 3-4 years? You didn't look at TV? Come on. Okay, but you got that during the fast, right? Or okay, you ain't got to talk about the ice cream, baby. I ain't ready for that. No, I'm just playing. But yeah. But so after this Paris thing, I was like, So I said, you know what? I ain't watching no news. Somebody had to tell me the about the stuff in California and all that. I'm like, I don't know. Because I'm like a sponge. You know, I am severely analytical. Almost over the critical. That's, I know me. That's, I'm like, well, golly, why couldn't they catch them when they come to border in Belgium and all that crazy stuff? I don't need all that. So I said, I ain't watching no news. I haven't watched any news since, I don't know, a couple weeks. Because I said, you know, I'm going to be an active force. I don't need a whole lot of other things consuming my mind that I can't do nothing about. My life, I got stuff going on in my life, man. I got stuff going on in my family. I got stuff going on in my business. I got stuff going on. I ain't got time for all this. I'm going to be the active force. I'm going after it. Mike, you got me all off my message, though. But, okay, so the spirit part of me has completely changed. She stopped watching and eating ice cream. God bless her. But that was the decision she made. And nobody, I don't think nobody held a gun up to your head. But you're like, no. See, and that's, I know you say, well, that's not a, yes, it is a big deal. That's huge. Because the average person can't take control of themselves. And they always want to blame. Well, you know, I wouldn't eat no ice cream either, but you know, all these Christmas parties coming up. You know, I gained all this weight during the holiday. I lose it when we fast the pastor. When we gonna when we gonna fast, we okay, next month, I lose it all in. Okay, I see somebody been having that conversation. Okay, all right. But anyway. Nothing happened to the soul and to the body. So the soul needs to be upgraded. The body needs to be buffeted. All right. Y'all still with me? Okay. I think I'm, let's see. Okay, let me give you these scriptures, because this is what's happening in you. Like I said, Romans 8:11, that the same power to raise Jesus from the dead. Watch this. He's not just dwelling in you. He who raised Christ from the dead shall also give life to your mortal bodies through his spirit. In other words, he'll quicken whatever part of your body may be dying or got some issue. He said, he's in it. I need to get my soul to agree. I know I hurt, but I need to keep working until like my soul is as strong as that. Until my soul is as strong as that. And then my soul start connecting with that. And you know, it's like the nickel drops. You ever, sometimes you just know that, you know, nothing changed out here, but you just know, you know, I know how God deals with me. One of the ways God deals with me is I start laughing. I do it. I'm like, I be praying, and Father, I just think, I mean, the things I've been saying, that's the thing I've been standing for, Lord Jesus, for a long time. But it's good. But then I get, oh, Lord, thank you, Jesus. No, really. Sometimes, Father, I thank you. You redeem my life from destruction. Crown me with love and kindness. Oh, Lord, you're so good. That's how he deals with me. That's how I know the nickel dropped. Glory to God. Okay, he said this. Greater is he that's in me than he that's in the world. That's in there. Romans 5:5, he said, the love of God is shed abroad in my heart by the Holy Ghost. Because he said, love them even as I love you. I said, I can't do that, Jesus. He said, do it with the love I gave you. Yes. Oh, okay. Okay. You got that. But no, he said, no, just love them the way I love you. Now, it's all that love is already in you. So I said, Father, I thank you for the love of God that's in me. Man, we was working this over there. Love is patient. And it's kind while it's being patient. Love takes no account of a suffered wrong. Yeah, they did it, but you can't hold it against them. Love works no ill to its neighbor. Yeah, they did it, but you gonna put something on top of that. You're not gonna let everybody know they did it. Love doesn't rejoice when your enemy goes under. I was trying to tell them that I ain't the one. I'm not the one. You know you be wanting to do that. But love can't do that. Love got to be like, oh, Lord bless them. I hope they'll be okay. That's supernatural. That's supernatural. I remember one time, oh, Lord, don't tell that one. Okay. Don't tell that one. Ooh, Jesus. Okay, I just found it. I'm gonna say this, then y'all can go home. We can go home. I'm not gonna stay either. Okay. Ooh. Okay, look at your neighbor, make sure they're not sleeping. Because I wanna make sure they get this. If they're sleeping, push them out the chair. This is worth the price of admission. I don't know what the ushers charge y'all. Sometimes I know they're trying to get a commission at the door. I'm just playing. But no, this is good right here. This is worth the price of admission. The supernatural, remember we got this treasure in those vessels? The supernatural from your spirit to your physical realm stops when your soul agrees with your body or is dominated by the natural thing going on around you. Bad reports, your feelings, other things happening to other people. I'll say it again. Okay, I'm going to say it two more times. Dos. The supernatural from your spirit that's already in you, already in you. The supernatural from your spirit to your physical realm stops when your soul agrees with your body or what is happening naturally. Your feelings, bad reports, people that you respect telling you something. I believe in a lot of things, but I don't care who it is. There's only one Lord Jesus. Okay? So pastor ain't God either. And I say that when I mean that, sometimes, remember when Peter had to tell, Jesus had to tell Peter, get behind me? So anybody can yield to the devil. So I say that to say, there's times, you can just, whoever it is, it may be even me or if I'm your pastor, like, okay, I rebuke that. Now, you don't have to get up in my face and, do all that. You just like, okay. I do that all the time with y'all, some of y'all. They say, well, pastor, this is what I believe. I said, okay. You got anything else to say? Oh, I do. But it's not my place. I'm not your Lord. Now, if you ask me, so what do you think about it? Oh. Oh, that's different. Here's what I think. Now, so don't y'all be coming up and be asking me, Pastor Patrick, what you think about this? Because you probably, if you gotta ask that, you ain't settled on it yourself. And you just trying to get me to agree with you so you can go and do what you want to do. You know it ain't right. Okay. I will wait one more time. You know how people do that. I get that a lot, too. I'm like, man, don't. But I don't get as much as I used to. Because one time I said, I used the example. I said, if you don't ask me if I like your dress. Remember, I said, don't ask me if I like your dress because you didn't buy it for me, did you? No, I didn't buy it for you. Don't ask me. Let the people at the store tell you how wonderful it looks. Let Romeo, he'll tell you. You look marvelous. Don't come and ask Pastor. I might like it. And I may not, but I'm not going to lie. I'm not going to get in trouble. I'm not going to give the devil a place by lying. If I don't like it, I'm like, oh, no. I don't. So I'm not going to lie. And, I'm not going to waste a lie. I need to go back home, though. Yeah, I'm not going to wait. You don't waste no lie on your dress. I got to get some profit out of it. That's like, when you eating a low carb, they want to bring you a bunch of, no, I ain't wasting no carbs on that. Bring me some cheesecake. Four layers. Okay, let me say this one more time, then I'll let y'all go home. I'm sorry. The supernatural from your spirit to the physical realm stops when your soul agrees with your body. Man, that's huge. Well, because your body, man, I got one. And that body is persistent, ain't it? That body will get you out of bed at 4 o'clock in the morning. You know you want one of these. You don't want it. Or if you got an issue, there's some people just got to argue all the time with somebody. And they may get in the bed like, God, I ain't had no argument today. Let me call so-and-so. Yeah. No, I know that sounds funny, but some people do it, don't even know they're doing it. They just got to have one fight with somebody. They gotta argue with somebody, just disagree. Alabama ain't gonna win. Yes, they ain't gonna win. Okay, thank you. Good night. Just one. Really? It don't even mean nothing. Security, take him out. But, this sounds comical, but I'm talking about your body. Your body will go, because when I say body emotions, some people can't control their emotions. They don't want, I don't want to do this. I don't know why I keep doing this. Pastor, I got my computer and I drove down through a highway because I was out of control with this stuff and I just threw it in there because I said I can't be around a computer. But I went back to Best Buy. 4 days later and bought another one. And I'm right back where I was. $1,300 on my charge card. Because they couldn't control. You got to let that spirit, all that control was inside of you. He's giving us, what's that scripture? He's not giving us fear, but a power, love, and a sound discipline. Mind. No. Whether it's eating another piece of cake, computer, arguing, fussing, worrying. You just name it. That's all in the soul. That's all in the soul. Not thinking you're good enough. Not thinking that people care about you, pay attention to you. Not thinking that you're getting what's due to you. That's all in the soul. Thinking you're a failure. I'll just ride this thing out because I can never, you know. I'm 57 years old now. Look at me. When you sit there and have your pity party, beat yourself up. When all you got to do is go read Colonel Sanders' story. That'll inspire you. You know, that's all the soul. Feed your soul with stuff that's going to work for you. Be the active force with stuff that, because a lot of this stuff, you're feeding yourself, but it's not working for you. It's entertaining you, but it's not working for you. Some of the people you hang with, they're not, you enjoy them because they don't put up any resistance. They just let you, but you know it because you get out and say, I don't know why I'm even talking to them. Because they're not edifying you. They're not strengthening your resolve. They're not helping you, you know, navigate your way. God sent, I'm just flowing now. God sent people into your life for such a time as this to help you. And they may be just the one to help you to first base, but he got somebody else on deck to get you to second base. And you gotta know that. So when your soul is prospered, your expectation goes up like something good is gonna happen to me today. What happened yesterday does not define my future. I already know my best days are ahead of me. How do you know that? Because I just said it. And I can have what I say when I believe it. All that stuff that happened to me, all the mistakes I made, those were my classrooms. Those were my semesters. I had, those were my webinars. All that. I learned all that. I'm moving forward. Everybody say, I'm moving forward.
I'm moving forward.
Okay, let's stand up, everybody. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. I was talking to somebody yesterday, Pastor, and he said, boy, man, you looking forward to 2016? I said, no. I got a few more weeks than 15. I'm still believing God for. I said, 16 to get here if it get here. I want you to follow me. I don't know what I'm going to say. Let me say this with me, okay, based on what we just talked about, okay? First of all, let me tell you this. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Okay, this is the people here. These are the overcomers up in here. These are the winners up in here. These are the disciplines up in here. Okay, say this with me. In the name of Jesus. I am what God says I am. I have what God says I have. I can do what God says I can do. I am redeemed from destruction. I have the peace of God. My days of worry are over. My days of being offended are over.
My days of quitting are over.
Greater is he that is in me than he that is in the world.
There's
no devil in hell
that can stop me,
trick me.
In the name of Jesus,
I always triumph.
I always triumph.
Thanks be to God
who
gives me the victory.
This is the victory.
My faith
helps me overcome
anything.
Regarding my health.
With long life.
He
satisfies me. I'm not going to
live long and hurting.
I'm not going to live long with machine plugged into me.
I'm going to
be satisfied.
I decree
when germs,
viruses,
sicknesses,
diseases,
when that stuff
hits my
body,
it dies
instantly
in the name of
Jesus.
Because
the same power
that raised Jesus from the
dead
is quickening
me now.
Oh my
God.
I feel good.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Listen,
listen.
I'm strong
mentally,
physically,
spiritually,
financially,
relationship-wise,
whatever mistakes
I made,
it's under the blood.
I'm not
going to
cry over
mistakes
that I made.
My future
is too bright,
and I feel
like recovery,
recompense
of everything
that was either
stolen from me,
that I
messed up on.
I speak
recovery now.
In Jesus'
name.
I will
stand
with the strength
of God
until
manifestation,
until
I need to stop.
I will.
I said
I will.
I will be
the active
force.
I'm not waiting
on anybody else.
God
put greatness in
me.
And I'm going
for it.
I said
I'm going for it.
Starting
here tonight.
Now, Lord,
it's because
of you
that
I can have a
healthy expectation.
You know
what I'm dealing with
right now.
You know
what my children are
dealing with right now.
You know
when my money
is funny.
But tonight,
I'm about to
release something.
In fact,
I already have.
I believe
recovery.
I believe
divine alignments
is
occurring
in
my life.
Right now.
Lord,
I trust you.
And
I thank you.
Now
let's just give him a
nice praise offering.
Lord, we
thank you. You redeemed
our lives.
Thank you for
it in Jesus' name.
Thank you.
Greater is he that is in me.